Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series of manufacturing technology. Myself Dr. Vipul M. Patel from Dr. Subhash Technical Campus. So in previous lecture we have already discussed about the classification of welding and allied processes, right? So in this subject, in this lecture, in today's lecture, we will learn about the gas welding, oxyacetylene welding, then gas cutting and different types of flames. So today's lecture is very most important for the manufacturing technology, we can say, and gas cutting is one of the most important joining process which is included in the chapter number 3, that is metal joining processes. So we are going to start gas welding. We have already discussed some of the importance of the gas welding in the previous lecture, right? See, sound weld is obtained by selecting proper size of the flame, filler material and method of moving torch. See, the temperature generated during the process is 3000 degrees Celsius. When the metal is fused, oxygen from the atmosphere and the torch combines with the molten metal. See, oxy-fuel welding, which is commonly called oxyacetylene welding, oxy welding also we can say, and gas welding is also what we can use. See, this is the process that uses the fuel gases and oxygen to weld or cut the metal. See, in this process, torch is used to weld the metal. Welding metals results when two pieces are heated to a temperature that produces a sad tool of a molten metal. See, the molten pool is generally supplied with the additional metal, which is called filler. We say filler material or filler metal, we can say, right? So generally supplied with the additional metal, which is called as a filler. That material selection depends upon the metals to be welded. So which type of material or metal you want to join. So in oxy-fuel cutting, it is also, as we discussed, the torch is used to heat the metal, right? So a steam of the oxygen is then trained on the metal, burning it into the metal oxide that flows out of the cuff or slag, we can say, right? So torches that do not mix fuel with the oxygen are not considered oxy-fuel torch and can typically be identified by a single tank, I think. And two isolated supplies, fuel and oxygen, most of the metal cannot be melted with a single tank torch. So consequently, single tank torches are typically suitable for the soldering and brazing, but not for gas welding. So it is fluxes are also added to the welded metal to remove the oxides from the surfaces of the metal. Commonly flux used are made of the sodium, potassium, lithium and borax. Flux can be applied as a paste, powder, liquid, solid, coating or gases. So these are the different welding equipments we are using in the gas welding process. Is gas cylinder, first of all, both the cylinder we are using, one is for the oxygen and second is for the acetylene, which is near about 125 kg per cm square, and for the acetylene 16 kg per cm square, right? Then regulators we are using, which is with working pressure of oxygen 1 kg per cm square and working pressure of the acetylene 0.15 kg per cm square. So working pressure varies depend upon the thickness of the workpiece welding to be welded. Third one is important equipment, that is a pressure gauge. Then hoses, different hose pipes. Then torch, welding torch that we have already discussed. Check valves and non-return valves. So we can say different equipments used in the gas welding that consists basically of an oxygen source and a fuel gas source. Right? Two pressure regulators are also we are using, and two flexible hoses, one for each cylinder, one is for oxygen and second one is for acetylene, right? And this sort of the torch can also be used for the soldering and bearing process, right? Then regulators, yes, working pressure with 1 kg of cm square for the oxygen and 0.15 kg per cm square for the acetylenes. The regulator ensures that pressure of the gas from the tanks matches the required pressure in the hoses, which is useful. The regulator is useful to ensure that pressure of the gas from the tanks, which is coming from the tanks, that can match the required pressure in the hose or not. So the flow rate is that adjusted by the operator using needle valves on the torch and also accurate flow control with a needle valve release on the constant inlet pressure. So we can easily handle it with the regulators, right? Then hoses or gas hoses, we can say the hoses are designed for use in welding or cutting the metal. But a double hose or twin design can be used, meaning that the oxygen and fuel hoses are joined together. If separate hoses are used, they should be clipped together in the intervals of the approximately three feet apart. Although we can say that is not recommended for the cutting application, because beads of the molten metal given off by the process can become launched between the hoses, right? Then non-return valve, it is very most important equipment for the gas welding. Acetylene is not just flammable. In certain condition, it is explosive, we can say. So although it has an upper flammability limit in air of 81%, acetylene's explosive decomposition behavior makes this irrelevant. So if detonation valve enters in the acetylene tank, then tank will blow apart by decomposition. So ordinary check valves that normally prevent backflow cannot stop detonation valve because they are not capable for the closing. That's why in between the regulator and the hose, the ideally between hose and the torch on both oxygen and fuel lies. So flashback arrestor, right? That's why we are using non-return valve. Check valve is also important. Check valve lets gas flow in one direction only. It is usually a chamber containing a ball that is pressed against one end by a spring. So gas flow one way pushes the ball out of the way, right? That's why we are using check valve. Torch is also the tool that the welder holds and manipulates to make the weld, that we will also discuss in the next slide. It is also known as the oxyacetylene welding. So in this slide we will discuss about the some chemical reaction of the oxyacetylene welding. So utilize oxygen and fuel gas to heat the metal until it is in the molten state, and fuse multiple pieces of metal together, or it can be used with or without a filler metal, depends which type of material or metal you want to join with the use of this particular welding processes, right? Grate for brazing dissimilar metal together also, older technology that can be replaced by GTAW, gas tungsten, also known as a oxyacetylene welding. It is also known as a oxyacetylene welding. uses an oxy-fuel gas flame, can be applied with or without pressure, can be applied with or without the use of the filler metal. This is the process of oxyacetylene welding, we can say. CaC2 plus 2H2O is equal to CaOH2 plus C2H2. And C2H2 plus 2.5O2 is equal to 2CO2 plus H2O plus 306.800 calorie per mole. So this is the chemical reaction of the oxyacetylene welding, right? Hydrogen, gasoline, different fuel gases that can be used in the oxyacetylene welding processes. So in that, chemical reaction and temperature distribution in a natural oxyacetylene welding, you can see the figure of the primary combustion and secondary combustion in the flame. So where we are using the gas to enter in the torch, it is a torch. Here in inner zone, the temperature is about to 2800 to 3500 degrees Celsius. This one is a flame, and this one is the outer envelope of the flame. Over here, temperature is near about 2500 degrees Celsius, and over here, 1000 degrees Celsius. So this is the primary combustion in inner cone. 2C2H2 plus 2O2 from the cylinder, and we will get 4CO plus 2H2. And secondary combustion that will done in the outer envelope of the flame, 4CO plus 2O2 from the air, and 4CO2 we will get 2H2 plus O2, which is also from the air, and 2H2O. So the secondary combustion is also called the protection envelope, since CO and H2 here consume the O2 entering from surrounding air, right? Thereby protecting the weld from the oxygen. So what is the role of the oxygen in this gas welding? Anyone have idea regarding that? Oxygen is not the fuel, remember. It is what chemically combines with the fuel to produce the heat for the welding processes. And this process is called oxidation. What? Oxygen is not the fuel. Remember the role of the oxygen in gas welding. It is not the fuel. It is what chemically combines with the fuel to produce the heat for the welding process. And this welding process is known as a oxidation. But the more specific and more commonly used term, the context, it is combustion, right? In the case of the hydrogen, the product of the combustion is simply water. So for other hydrocarbon fuels, water and carbon dioxide are produced. So oxygen is usually produced elsewhere by the distillation of the liquefied air and also come from the air. So this is the role of the oxygen. This is the apparatus of the oxyacetylene welding, and this one is this cylinder is for the acetylene, this cylinder is for the oxygen. These are the regulators. We already discussed about the application of each and every equipments which we are using in the oxyacetylene or gas welding processes. This one is a valve, application of the valve we have discussed. This is a torch, this one is a workpiece. And this is the direction of the welding, figure A. Figure B, it is a welding area. Primary combustion in the flame, secondary combustion in the flame. This one is a filler rod. If we required, which type of material or metal we want to join with the use of the gas welding processes. This is the protection envelope. It is a metal droplet from the filler rod. It is a slag. It is a welding metal, base metal we can say. This one is a weld pool, right? Oxyacetylene mixture which is come from the cylinder with the use of the different equipments, right? One more thing, that is oxy-fuel process may use a variety of fuel gases, the most common being acetylene, and other gases that may be used propylene. It is also liquefied petroleum gas, LPG. So propane is a natural gas, hydrogen and MAP gas. Many plants use different kinds of gases in their mixtures, right? So these are the different equipments and apparatus, we can say, for the oxyacetylene welding processes. This is the main equipments with zoomed figure: acetylene cylinder, oxygen cylinder, oxygen regulators. This one is a fuel gas or acetylene regulators, we can say. This one is a valve. This is a plug. It is a support for the standing of the cylinder. This is an oxygen hose pipe. This is a fuel hose pipe that will mix over here in the torch, and with the use of this torch we can develop the flame to raise the temperature on the base metal for the gas welding processes. Gas cutting. Ferrous metal is heated into red hot condition and a jet of pure oxygen projected into the surface, which rapidly oxidizes. Right. Oxidize having lower melting point than the metal and melt and are blown away by the force of the jet to make a cut. So with the use of this gas welding processes, if we can join the metal or material like that, also we can cut the metal or material. With the use of this apparatus also. See, oxy-fuel torches are to have been used for the heating the metal. So in automotive and other industries, for the purpose of losing the sized fasteners, or natural flame is also used for joining and cutting of all the ferrous and non-ferrous metal, except brass. So fast and efficient method of the cutting steel to the high degree of accuracy, it is gas cutting. Torch is different from the welding processes. Thus, torch we are using for the gas welding, it is different for the gas cutting. And cutting torch is has preheat orifice and central orifice for oxygen jet. Piercing and gauging are two important operation. So piercing used to cut a hole at the center of the plate or away from the edge of the plate. Gauging is to cut a groove into the steel surface. जो steel surface है उसमें हमें groove cut करना है, उसे हम gauging करते हैं. और piercing जो हम hole को center से cut करते हैं, to cut the hole at the center of the plate or away from the edge of the plate, it is called piercing, right? Then it is gas cutting. Then types of flame. I hope all of you idea regarding the types of flame. Mainly there are three types of flame in oxyacetylene welding, which is called natural flame, reducing flame and oxidizing flame. See, the welder can adjust the oxyacetylene flame to be carburizing, neutral or oxidizing. Adjustment is made by the adding more or less oxygen to the acetylene flame. The natural flame is flame most generally used for the welding or cutting. The welder uses the natural flame as the starting point for all other flame adjustments because it is so easily defined, and this flame is attained when the welder as they slowly open the oxygen valve on the torch body. First, see only two flames joins at the point, and the acetylene is being completely burned in the welding oxygen and surrounding air. So natural flame is for the acetylene, C2H2 and oxygen O2 are mixed in the equal amounts and burn at the tip of the welding torch, and the inner zone gives 2/3 of the heat, whereas the outer envelope provides 1/3 or 1/3 of the energy. And reducing flame, the excess amount of acetylene is used giving a reducing flame. The combustion of the acetylene is incomplete between the inner cone and the outer envelope. So the good welding aluminium alloys, high carbon steels and oxidizing flame is the excess amount of oxygen is used and giving an oxidizing flame. This is good for the welding brass. Right? A flame is applied to the base metal and held until a small puddles of the melted metal is formed in the welding processes. And usually more metal is added to the puddle as it is moved along by dipping the metal from the welding rod or filler rod into the molten metal puddle. The metal will travel towards where the metal is the hottest, and this is accomplished through the torch manipulation by the welder. Another thing that is, this is a figure of the different types of flame in oxyacetylene welding. First one is a natural flame. You can see the inner zone of the natural flame. Second one is a reducing flame. You can see the inner zone of the reducing flame, and acetylene feeder is also there. And third one, that is the oxidizing flame. Temperature. In different flames, in oxidizing flames, the inner cone temperature is near about 3500 degrees Celsius. In carburizing flame, temperature is about to 3150 degrees Celsius in inner zone, and natural flame it is about to 3400 degrees Celsius in the neutral flame. Oxygen is turned on, flame immediately changes into the long white inner area surrounded by the transparent blue envelope is called carburizing flame. What is natural flame? Addition of the little more oxygen give a bright whitish cone surrounded by the transparent blue envelope is called natural flame. Used for the welding steels, aluminium, copper and cast iron. Neutral flame. Then used, then if more oxygen is added, the cone becomes darker and more pointed, while the envelope becomes shorter and more fierce, is called oxidizing flame and has the highest temperature about 3400 degrees Celsius. Used for the welding brass and brazing operations. Right? For the basic oxyacetylene rig, the cutting speed in the light steel section will usually be nearly twice as fast a petrol driven cutoff grinder. Robotic oxyfuel cutter is also used sometime at high speeds if divergent nozzle we are using. One more thing, that is oxyacetylene can cut only low to medium carbon steel. Right? And there are most of the important thing is safety. So in oxyacetylene welding or cutting is not difficult, but there are a good number of subtle safety points that should be learned, such as we have already studied about the safety features in the manufacturing process. So more than 1/7 the capacity of the cylinder should not be used per hour. Acetylene is also dangerous, above one atom or pressure we can say. Proper ventilation when welding will help to avoid the large chemical exposure. For the eye protection, proper protection such as welding goggles. It should be worn all the times when you are run the gas welding apparatus. Then including the protect of the eyes against the glare and flying sparks also. So all these things are important. Safety with the cylinders also. Chemical exposures, we can say, flashbacks, all these things you have to remember when you run the gas welding apparatus. This is the zoomed figure of the natural flame and where the temperature, different temperature stages of the different temperature rise during this natural and natural flame in the oxyacetylene welding process. Three basic types of oxyacetylene flame is used: oxyfuel, gas welding and cutting operations, natural flame, oxidizing flame and carburizing, or it is also called reducing flame. So this one is a natural, neutral or neutral. Oxidizing flame is also there. You can see the figure of this oxidizing and carburizing flame, which is also called as a reducing flame, right? These are the apparatus of the gas welding process: is oxygen cylinder, as we seen in the figure, acetylene cylinder, pressure gauges for both the cylinders, valve for the both the cylinders, hose pipe for the both the cylinders, torch where we can mix up that fuel and oxygen, then welding tip, pressure regulators which can maintain the pressure from the pressure of the cylinder, oxygen as well as acetylene, lighter to produce the flame first of all, and goggles which can protect the eyes, right? You can see the live figure of this gas welding processes: hoses, blow pipes, then acetylene cylinder and oxygen cylinders, valves which can handle the which can send the oxygen as well as fuel, acetylene, to the torch, then outlet pressure gauges, cylinder pressure gauges, pressure regulating screw, so which can adjust the pressure flow, all these things, right? This one is a torch, and important parts of the torch. Torch mouth, first one you can see. Then second one is a mixing tube mouth over here. Second one, it is a mixing tube where we can mix the fuel and oxygen. Third one is an injector. It is a injector, third one. Fourth one is a mixing nozzle. Oh, it is a nozzle. Mixing nozzle, we can say. Fifth one is a pressure nozzle, you can see over here. Sixth one is a acetylene valve. Seventh one is a oxygen valve. Eighth one is a grip, so welder can easily hold the torch in their hand. Ninth one is a entrance of the acetylene, and tenth one is a entrance of the oxygen. This is the live figure and figure of the torch with the welding tip and mixture or handle for the welder, you can see. And how we can use the filler rod in the gas welding with the which type of material or metal we want to join with the use of the gas welding depends which type of filler metal or material we have to use, right? These are the advantages and disadvantages of the gas welding processes. It is a very simple equipment. We can use it at any place. It is a portable. If you want to change the place of this apparatus, then we can also change it. And it is not very much expensive, or we can say inexpensive. Easy for the maintenance and repair. Then disadvantages of the gas welding: limited power density, very low welding speed compared to the arc welding, high total heat input per unit length, large heat affected zone, sewer distortion, and not recommended for the welding reactive metals such as titanium and zirconium. So it is the gas welding process. From the next lecture, We will start, or in the next lecture, we will learn about the arc welding processes and other things. So today it is enough, and thank you all. Thank you all.